It is no secret that a challenging, meaningful job makes people happier. But did you know that the very same job might also help prevent a deadly disease? Teachers, electricians, and civil engineers are just some of the professions that could protect your brain against Alzheimer's disease. My name is Polly Moyart. I'm a nuclear medicine resident, and ever since I was a little girl, I was interested in how our brains work. This is one of the reasons why I moved to Canada and became part of an international team of dementia researchers. In this short video, I will tell you how your job could reduce your risk of developing Alzheimer's disease. Research shows that people with cognitively stimulating jobs tend to stay mentally sharper, which may delay the onset of Alzheimer's disease by about 2 years. Mentally stimulating jobs involve a lot of critical thinking, analyzing, and problem solving, and can be viewed under three categories. First, we have the thinkers. Thinkers are creative and analytical and come up with new ideas to solve a problem. Some examples include financial analysts, civil engineers, musicians, and architects. Then we have the builders. Builders are very hands-on, realistic, active, and frequently outdoors. Examples are carpenters, plumbers, and electricians. And finally, we have the improvers. Improvers are friendly, outgoing, and supportive. They are devoted to helping people and communities work through challenges they face in everyday life, just like teachers, social workers, and nurses do. All of these jobs keep people intellectually stimulated, which helps build what we call our cognitive reserve. The cognitive reserve is our brain's attempt to compensate for any damage to our brain tissues. As we age, areas of our brain cells degenerate over time, a process which may be slowed down by exercising our brain. Think of our brain as a city. Just like there are a bunch of destinations connected by roads, in the brain there are a bunch of different areas connected by brain cells or neurons. Just like traffic flows along the roads of the city, activity flows along these neuron tracks when you try to remember something. Therefore, the more we keep our brain stimulated, the better our brain can use the cognitive reserve we've built up to create new roadways to get from A to B. While having a stimulating job won't stop damage from happening, it will create other mechanisms to counterbalance it. But for many of us, the complexity of our job is not something we can easily change. Luckily, there are other ways to build our cognitive reserve. One study that I love to talk about is the religious order study. This study looked at nuns living in the same environment, no drug use, no alcohol, and similar housing and nutrition. Researchers studied these nuns throughout their lives, and they were regularly questioned about their time spent doing intellectually stimulating activities. Nuns who reported doing more cognitively stimulating activities like reading, playing games, or learning a new language showed a reduced risk for developing dementia of up to 47% later in their lives. This study shows us that not only mentally stimulating jobs, but also getting involved in a wide variety of activities and hobbies might also be protective against Alzheimer's disease. More research is needed, but these studies demonstrate that it's possible to protect our brains in order to hold on to who we are for as long as possible. The brain is like a muscle. Use it or lose it. We can't stop the process of aging, but by training our thinking muscle, we may be able to slow it down.